Morning, Letter Fam. So today we will be doing some stuff to the Honda. Finally, I'm going to change up a few stuff on the Honda, and one of those things I'm going to change up are the tailpiece. Second thing I'm going to change up on the car is the grill, because I basically swapped the grill with Keanu. I think his name is Keanu Norris from Joburg or Pretoria. So I posted my grill up to him, and he posted his down to me. So I received these. But the grill is a little bit loose and there's a little bit overspray on, but that's not a problem because I'm going to fix it up today and I'm going to put it on the car. I might change the lip to a Prelude lip. At the moment I have the SIR lip on my car, so I will be changing it to the Prelude lip. And I just wanted to change the car in total because I wanted to seem like my car and the look I always wanted to go with the car. And the Prelude lip is the lip I always wanted on my Honda and never got time to purchase one or to actually fit one on my Honda. And luckily Jody bought himself a SIR lip, which he fitted on the Civic. So I will be taking his Prelude lip for the time being and put it on my car, and maybe just buy one in the future. And then we're just gonna install the tailpiece. I'm gonna find a place to give me a reasonable price to weld on the other tailpiece, because this current tailpiece has the Powerflow stamp on, but it's tailpiece has like a slant downwards, and I'm really not a fan of that slant. So a tailpiece I have right here is actually I think it will be suitable for the car because it's quite big, and you guys can see it is straight, and it is still a brand new tailpiece. It was only used I think like once or twice, whereas I never used. I got it by Jody. I still need to pay him for that though, so don't tell him that. So I still need to pay him for that. I'm currently in front of Jody's house waiting for him to come out so that we can start off today. It's gonna be a long day, so be with us, and I'm gonna try to edit the video as short as possible for all of you guys. And I hope you guys are enjoying the content this far for this channel. There are still loads of content coming up, so please do subscribe to my channel right now and please like this video. If you guys want to get notified whenever I'm uploading new content, please click the little bell next to the subscribe button.
Hey!
Hierdie slaap. Yes, bruh, mas bruh, for the content.
Many, many minutes later.
Sebastian just did the measurements, so if you check it from the bumper, I want the tailpiece to be around here, just a little bit inward from the bumper. And also I don't want it to be too in, and there will be a lot of smoke, or basically feel burned. Yo, that looks crap, bro. Imagine that was your tailpiece though. Imagine that was your tailpiece. Look how massive this thing is. This thing is for sale though. So this is a Powerflow, original Powerflow tailpiece, which I won't be using again and will be for sale. So you guys can hit me up on Instagram if you guys are interested in this tailpiece. I'll DM you guys the price back for the tailpiece, and the price will be in the description below for the tailpiece as well. So you guys can just contact me on Instagram. I'll clean up the tailpiece a little bit later so you guys can see how it actually looks. Alright, so all the measurements was taken, and Sebastian is gonna weld the smaller extended part to the tailpiece first before he actually welds it to the box again. So now at the moment he's just gonna weld everything together and put it and basically put it nice in the center, and after that he's basically just gonna tilt it up so it can be equal to the bumper.
Years later.
So we're back at the house and the tailpiece is fitted. So now we're gonna start off with the bumper, fitting the grill, fitting the patch onto the grill, fitting the grill onto the bumper. So it's gonna be a complete, or basically a long process. I'm just gonna show you guys how the tailpiece looks on the car. Oh, fuck, I'm dark. Damn. But yeah, I'm just gonna show you guys the dirt boots on the car. You guys can basically do your own judgment of how it looks on the car. So that's how the tailpiece looks on the car. To me, that's exactly what I wanted. It's basically just a little bit more out than what it should be. But that prevents any smoke onto the bumper, or basically overfueling smoke onto the bumper. And that's exactly which I don't want. So that's the reason why I had to put the tailpiece out the way it is. But for me, I'm totally satisfied. I mean, like, it has the exact same look that my previous car or my previous Honda had on. And I'm grateful that I could resurrect it, basically resurrect it on this car. So now it's only just chilling here in the sun, finding a tan. But after this, we are gonna definitely start with the bumper. So I'm gonna start screwing everything off, removing the bumper, and then after that, we're gonna start prepping the grill to fit it onto the bumper. And then I have this lip of Jody here. This lip has been chilling here for quite some time, this one here. So it's not damaged to anything, but this was the lip that was on the Civic. So I'm gonna put this lip onto my car, because my lip is cracked around here somewhere. So I'm just gonna put this one on my car, because this is basically the look I always wanted to go. And basically she already knows that. So luckily there at Quickfit there is a guy who actually who's willing to help me fix the current lip on my car. This is the SRR lip on my car. So I'm gonna fix the lip by him. He's just gonna do a fiberglass welding or something like that to fix up the lip. And then after that, the lip will basically get resprayed again. And after that, the lip will basically be looking brand new. Guys can see right there. That's where the lip basically broke. And there's cracks here everywhere. This happened this morning on the lift when I was welding the basically the tailpiece onto the car. Guys can see the cracks all the way right there. So this lip will be coming off the car, and you guys can see right there the car is grillless. Like, I'm just smiling now. It's gonna turn. Still clean, eh? Very clean. So I need to respray this valve cover, because the valve cover didn't come out as I wished, because you could see at Honda day, that the red Mugen valve covers, how it actually should look like. And I felt like quite embarrassed how mine looks compared to the rest of the people. And this manifold cover definitely needs to get replaced, because doesn't look as good with the rust stuff there and everything like that. And then there's a few modifications I still want to do to the engine body, but that's minor. So let's get started straight away by removing the bumper. At the moment, Jody is removing the lip, or basically just removed the lip. We're gonna first respray the pre-loop lip that was on his car, or basically on Lisa's car previously. So we're first gonna respray that lip and prep it a little bit to make it look a little bit better, because the more presentable it looks, the better it actually looks on the car. And while he was stripping the bumper, I was actually removing some of the overspray on the scrolls here, as you guys can see. There was a lot of overspray on the grill. You guys can see that there is a lot of overspray. But luckily for me, that overspray will not be seen. And I just removed all the overspray on the edges around here. And I removed some of the glue of the double-sided tape Keanu had on this batch right here. And here was some overspray at the back as well, which I removed as well. Right around, I actually removed some of the overspray. And this clip right here, I think, broke in the shipping process, so I'm just gonna try and glue that clip right there. And then this is the patch we have. So the patch also, I'm gonna try, I don't think this is the correct size patch for the grill, But if you guys look at it, it actually looks alright. So I'm gonna try and silicone or glue this patch to the grill as well. And while I'm doing that, I think Jody's gonna start prepping the lip, and we're gonna start right off with the spray painting after that. While I got the patch on, now I really siliconed the patch on. I tried to rescue this clip on that side, and I removed all the overspray this far, so I'm good with that. But now it's time to start with this lip right here. So we're gonna start off with the lip. Jody already sanded it down slightly with 1005 sandpaper. I cleaned it up with some engine cleaner and some clean water. So now we're gonna use VHD to spray this lip, and hopefully it will give a nice metallic black, because the metallic black is exactly what I'm looking for on this car, because because the metallic black makes the car's fronts like stand out like completely, and it makes it stand out like very, very well. I almost forgot that one of the speedings here at the back, I also still need to silicone. I almost forgot about the speeding, you see like there. It's a little bit loose, so I need to silicone it to be seated just like that. After I'm done with that, then we'll be basically almost be done with the car. So it's just the grill, just the lip, just the back part, and just to refit the bumper, and then we'll be good to go. Well, it has been like 20 minutes since I last sprayed the third coat on this lip, and you guys can see it looks amazing. I mean, like, even I'm surprised on how I sometimes spray with a spray can. So the results are amazing on this this front lip, or this basically more known as the prelude lip, and then even on the grill. I mean, like, I think the silicone is kind of dry, so I'm gonna let this like stay for a while, and I'm rather gonna move on to the lip, and first time fit the lip onto the bumper and see how far we get from there. But I'm gonna let it sit for another 10 or 20 minutes just to make sure that it's completely dry. But it has like a nice glitter effect on it, and it looks like, yo, it looks amazing. I swear people will think I spray with a gun just for this off finishing right here. But yeah, not to brag too much about myself, you know. Just kidding. And I actually did the beading over here. I did put some silicone and I actually taped it up, so I'm going to let it set like that for some time. Ik is lekker moeg. Jody! Well, the front end is kind of done. You can see, luckily, both those panels are straight, so meaning the car is actually straight and wasn't any accident damage or anything like that. And when you unlock these bolts right here and this one right here, then you can basically move the light inwards or outwards. So I just moved it all the way inwards, so that if you check the cast off finishing from the front, you will have a nice flush look from the lights all the way through the grill to the other light and right around the car. So yeah, we're just basically waiting for the lip and the grill to dry before we continue doing what we're doing. But at the time, I mean, we're just chilling here. Me and Jody already started with the lip, so I'm just gonna put you guys on a nice cinematic or shit like that, so you guys can just see while we're fitting the lip. We'll be right back. are done with everything on the scar right now. So we're done with the beadings, we're done with the pumper, we're done with the grill, we're done with the lip. All I need to do, I just need to remove these stickers on the side. I'm not really a fan of the stickers. I just want to get me a better Doc VTEC kind of vibe or blood sticker for the back doors. But I'm going to remove that. And then here is how the car looks in front. It gives a very stock Omish look. And I'm so grateful for the results on this car, because I mean, like, it's everything I always wanted for like a Ballard or any Honda Ecri type car. But this is like the looks that I really wanted to pull off on any of my EKs, but I never got time to actually pull it off. So I'm really grateful for pulling off this look. There is a little bit of hole style still somewhere around here that's sticking out of the previous lip. Due to the previous owner, how he fitted the previous lip, only he knows. Because he put in way too many screws to hold up the lip, and he went a little bit overboard. You guys can see right here, it's sticking out right there. So I'm not really a fan of that, but I'm grateful for how the car actually came out. Look how amazing the car looks. It looks so amazing. So all I'm going to do right now, I'm just going to remove the back sticker right there. But I'm grateful for the outcome. So this will be the end of the video today. So guys, please just like this video and subscribe to my channel, and please do click that little bell right there, because that little bell will notify you whenever I'm uploading new content on this channel. So please guys, please, without you I can't do it. Leave a comment, leave a like. What do you guys think of this car? What do you guys think I should do next to the car? Should I put in cams? Should I lower it even more? Should I buy coilovers? What should I do to this car? I know I might buy semi-clear soon, so the semi-clears are on its way, you don't have to worry about that, but anything else in this car. But thanks guys, and enjoy your day.